Get ready to match the stars. Bill Daly, Brent Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Lee Merriweather, Richard Dawson, and Betty White as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Reber.
Thank you very much. Thank you, friends, for joining us here. Grand bunch. I think we got a groovy group out there today, so we're going to do our best for them. Now, I just got a couple of things. It's Mary Tyler Moore, Barnaby Jones, and Bob Newhart. Now let's see. Now,
You're on Bob Newhart.
You're on Mary Tyler Moore, and you're on
the religious side,
Barnaby Jones. Right? Okay, all that's out
she
of the way.
She is Barnaby
now.
Jones.
Family.
Is.
And you're wearing a.
Look at him. No.
You're wearing a.
Look,
this
stand-up.
Highest rated show in daytime television. You're wearing a sweatshirt.
This happens to be from one of the most famous shops in Beverly Hills. And it's not a fake Indian print.
Nevertheless, it's a sweatshirt, and this is a classy show, Charles Nelson Reilly.
He has classy
Riley.
Sweat, so it's all right.
Oh, okay.
And he isn't wearing any socks?
No, I know.
Or
but
anything.
Or any shorts?
You feel rejected, Charles?
I'll be all right.
Let's say hello to Evelyn Collins and Terry Gerber. Hey.
Thank you.
Evelyn's a current champ. She's won a lot of money. She has $6,800 to her credit. Now she's being challenged by Terry Gerber, who had very good fortune with her first round question, which, you know, the first rounders are a little tougher. We'll see how you do with yours in a moment or so, but right now, let's see about this. Breathe in. Here we go. Push this button and reveal our other first round question for Evelyn Collins and ask you to respond to this. You heard of the movie A Man Called Horse?
No, but if you hum a few bars...
Movie Man Called Horse. There's a new movie about Ugly Edna. The title is A Girl Called Blank.
That's it.
What's that?
The last couple of weeks, we've gone back to our old chauvinist ways.
Ugly Edna.
We used to. Yeah, we used. Remember, we mixed them up.
Oh yeah, that's right.
Dumb Dora, Dumb Donald.
Yeah. Now we got Dumb Donald. Right.
Well, now we've had a lot of ugly lady jokes.
You don't like ugly.
Well, let's be fair and have a few ugly men as well. All right.
Listen.
Yeah. You're not going to mention anything, all right?
You didn't shave.
Well, I'll tell you why I didn't shave.
You didn't shave with this? I'm raising heck with him because it's a high-class
well,
number one daytime
show. I'll
tell
you why I didn't have time to shave.
Why?
I was busy dressing Charles.
Oh, all right.
It took me an hour.
All right, here we go. Now, Evelyn, you've heard of the movie A Man Called Horse. Have you really, indeed? You're
yes,
not
I
just
have.
Saying yes to say
no.
Yes, are you? No.
No, I've heard of it.
There's a new movie out about Ugly Edna. The title is A Girl Called...
Dog.
Dog it is for her.
See, so you've got to be fair.
Right.
Tell the legend.
Right. See, some ugly Edward jokes or
yeah,
something
right.
would be,
yeah,
you know, if you can
I'm
do that. Because women, you know, we don't want to offend anybody here.
I'm sorry I blew that because I love dogs. I think they're cute. I said a girl named Ape.
A girl called Ape.
Well, I got a couple chuckles out of that. That's not bad.
Brett, hello.
Hello, darling.
I love you.
Hang in with me, Evie. I
belong. Doggy! There's one for Evelyn Collins.
Wait, you put her last week the answer.
Yes, you were. Good thing about
see,
it. What?
A dog is not ugly to me. I have lovely dogs.
Yeah.
So I said a girl named Anne.
A girl called Anne.
Anne Teeter.
Anne Teeter. Anne Teeters are ugly. They are mighty ugly.
Getting good.
But Charles,
Teeter, that's
a
good stage
there is a common expression, a phrase in the vernacular. Boy, look at that girl. Isn't she a dog? You know, have you ever heard that?
Well, that's disgusting.
Yeah, it is disgusting.
You'd never say, look at that girl. She's an anteater.
No, you'd never say that. Speaking of dogs, hello, Lee. Yeah. What do you got there for us?
Well, I went along with horse and said mule.
Mule.
I don't know.
That'll do it, yeah.
Girl
the girl called mule.
I don't know. No.
What do you say, unshaven one?
Well... I said dog.
Dog!
That's 2-3. Evelyn scores now 4-2.
Now, this, I know this, you're not deeply offended, are you? Just offended a little bit?
Just surfacely.
Yeah, just surfacely, yeah. So you wouldn't say dog.
I hated to use any animal. I was going to say sin, as ugly as sin, but I had to use an animal because of horse, so I said, would all the pigs in the audience please forgive me?
All right. A girl called pig. Okay, now we go to round two, and we ask Terry to make her selection. Scores 4-2, Terry, in your favor.
B, please.
B it is. Now, there are two people who play, Charles and Lee. All right?
What about me?
You do not.
Oh, okay.
Charles?
I was just checking.
Yo.
Charles, Dumb Donald is so dumb.
How dumb.
A little more rehearsal for the audience, John. Dumb Donald is so dumb, before the swimming race, for good luck, Donald slipped a blank into his trunks.
Dumb Donald is so dumb,
before the swimming race, for good luck, Donald slipped a blank into his trunks.
Boy, am I glad I don't have to answer that question.
For good luck, he did that.
Oh, that's
okay.
Nice.
Now we come over to Terry Gerber, who's been thinking about this. Put it in the slot, Charles. All right, he's doing a little artwork on it, but he is ready. Dumb Donald is so dumb, Terry. Before the swimming race, for good luck, Donald slipped a blank into his trunks.
It's got to be an anchor.
A what?
If he's dumb, an anchor?
Now, wait a minute.
No, they are
a
good,
a weight, you know, like
no,
an
it's
anchor.
A good luck symbol. That's your answer.
Well,
anchor
an anchor is,
what we
is
have
that,
to...
Gene?
An anchor is a good luck symbol?
Well, I had one on me.
Well,
here.
No, that's, I don't think that's not my idea what a good luck symbol is. What do you
me
say, Charles?
A
Chacho's horseshoe.
Horseshoe is a good luck symbol, you see. And it would be so heavy, Terry, that it would weight him down.
Anchor's
an anchor
too.
Would weight him down more, but it's not the traditional good luck symbol. What do you say, my dear?
Well, to go along with Chucky Bibi horseshoe.
You said horseshoe there. All right, so we're in the middle of round two. Score remains 4-2. Evelyn, you got a chance to tie it up and possibly win it right after we pass along this message. Now, let's see how this game ends. Evelyn Collins, 2-tie, 3-win. And Bill and Charles and Lee and Betty will participate in this.
Okay.
When Margaret Murphy, the richest woman in the world, goes to a nudist camp, she's easy to spot. She's the one with the monogrammed blanks.
Seriously?
Yeah.
She's the one with the monogrammed blanks.
The one with the monogrammed blanks is Margaret Murphy, the richest woman in the world.
Richest woman in the world.
Easy to spot her at a nudist camp because she has monogrammed blanks.
Did you notice that I got it right, folks? I don't care. I mean, that's
you don't let right.
You're quick
that's
to
right.
challenge me when I'm wrong. But look at this. 2 times I haven't.
Terrific.
Right. Okay. I think that's a first for this
Splendid.
Show.
Splendid.
Don't
Bill,
you?
What did you do?
She's completely naked, right?
Yes, nudist camp. That's what you do. You're completely naked.
You know, I'm so shy. I always wear something, you know.
Really?
Yeah, rats.
She's easy to punch. She's
nice.
The one with
that's
the monogram blanks.
That's a sweet answer. I like that.
All right, here we go. Evelyn Collins. When Margaret Murphy, the world's richest woman, goes to a nudist camp, she's easy to spot. She's the one with the monogrammed blanks.
Boobs.
Oh.
What?
I said that, eh? Now, Evelyn, what are your grandchildren going to say to that? I ask you.
Expression.
Oh, really?
Oh. I'm shocked, Evelyn.
Leanne Meriwether's fainted.
Mouth-to-mouth resuscitation.
I don't have to put up with this.
Ah, yes, you do. What do you say, Bill?
Wait, well, I have to fix his
wait a minute. Money. I was going to say that, but I got a children's show, so I can't do that.
Go ahead.
Oh, I put navel, but she put navels down. So
navels.
Yeah, navel.
Yeah, she had a lady with two navels.
I didn't get a boo on that.
She was so
dull.
Rich, she had two navels there. What do you say, Charles?
I said boobs.
Boobs.
Well, thank you, Scores 4-3.
4-3 the score now. You need one more, or a pair to tie. And, Now we find out what Lee Meriwether is offering. Oh, there it is. That's another pair. We got a tie score. Bazooms. Bazooms. Hello, Betty White.
Hello, Gene. What was this lady's name?
Margaret Murphy, the richest woman in the world.
Richest woman in the world. Unfortunately, hers weren't a match. No, but... Boobs.
Boobs wins again.
Congratulations.
So here we are again.
again.
Okay, you hang around on the adhesive tape there. We're going to say goodbye to Terry Gerber, who's got a smile on her face in spite of the fact that she did not win, but she will be receiving many gifts from us here at Match Game 76. Goodbye,
thank
Terry
you.
Gerber. Now, this is your third shot at it. If you go all the way here and win the big bundle, you could get over $10,000 altogether, you know, because you got $6,900 now, and another $5,000 or $5,500 would really put you over that big mark. Now, we polled a recent studio audience, Evelyn, and we got their best response to this. Heaven blank. Now, remember, the answer that bunch gave most frequently is worth $500 to you if you match it. If you match the middle one, you get $250 and then $100 for the bottom one. And let's see what kind of help we'll get from our celebrities.
Charles.
Heaven on earth.
Heaven on earth. Lovely thought. Okay.
When I say every day I have to do this show, heaven help us.
Heaven help us. Richard?
Heaven is a four-letter word. No.
Now, wait a minute. He's thinking. Give him a chance.
Several.
The third is a tough spot.
This is regarding whether we're going to win the big money. Heaven only knows.
Heaven only knows. Yeah.
Duda.
All right.
There's others.
There are others. So, heaven only knows. Heaven on earth and heaven help us.
Well, heaven girly brown.
And heaven girly brown, yes, that's a very popular one too.
Richard, say, I'm going with Richard. What?
With Richard, heaven only knows?
Heaven only knows.
Yes. It's unusual, I point out to you, for the third choice among our celebrities to be the winner.
Now you tell me.
Well, no, if you've been watching the show, you know that's the way it is. Okay.
She's so rich now, she doesn't care.
That's right. Well, we're looking for Heaven Only Knows. Let's begin at the bottom and reveal the $100 response. Heaven Help Us is up there. That's the one that Brett gave you.
I thought that would be that.
Let's find out if Heaven Only Knows is under the $250 number. Heaven and Earth. Heaven on Earth. That's the one that Charles gave you. It's fairly close, but not an exact match. Last chance for Heaven Only Knows. Here is the $500 number. Heaven Sent. Yes. Well, that's unusual. Our celebrities usually... Did you have it, Betty? Heaven Sent?
In my head, but
in
that,
your head.
That doesn't mean
anything. Okay, well, there it is. Now, Evelyn, you enrich yourself by $100 by winning the game, and you will play another game in a little bit, but right now we want to do this message just for you. Hello there. Ready? Oh, hello there. I say we applaud Jim Gregory over here. Hi, Jim. Nice. Good. Let's find out all about you, where you're from and all that.
I'm from Fort Jones, California. I'm 26, single.
Yeah.
Rider and a boilermaker.
You're a boilermaker?
Construction worker.
Oh, yeah. Where do you boiler make? Everywhere?
Anything that's loose.
Oh, really? With rivets and all that?
No, mostly it's welding, fitting.
Oh. Let's see your hands. Turn them around, man. You have no calluses. Oh, yes, you do. Oh, he's tough. All right. He's tough, Evelyn. I'll fool around with him, okay? All right, Jim. Go, here.
Eight, please.
Eight is for Jim Gregory. Dumb Dora, so dumb.
How dumb is he?
You're getting better. You're getting better. There. She tried to teach a hot dog to blank.
She won't. I'm sorry. I missed that.
Dumb Dora, so dumb. She tried to teach a hot dog to blank.
Got it.
Oh.
Good answer. Got it.
All right. Good for you, folks. Jim Gregory. Dumb Dora so dumb she tried to teach a hot dog to blank.
Roll over.
Roll over. I thought this was going to be a shoe-in.
Bill said, boy, I love that one. I got it this time. I'm not worried
so
about
it. So far off, it's the worst. Oh, I thought that was great. Well, I have taught my hot dog to sit up. I thought that was great.
Well, sit up is good.
Yeah, see?
Sit up is good.
Sit up is good. He was, no, he was so sure it was finally going to be a match.
Aren't they adorable?
What are you saying?
Well, I didn't get it right either. I like his answer. It was that he's worried he wasn't going to match, but I told him not to worry about that. I said, you know, the real Jim Gregory is cute as a button and plays the lieutenant on Barney Miller. Why don't we have him on our show?
Yeah, why don't we get Jim Gregory on the show there?
He's adorable and funny as a crutch. I said go on the paper.
Go on the paper.
Did you put him right down? You taught a hot
No, those are all good. I like those, Charles.
Your hot dog rolls over when it's in the little glass thing cooking, and when you get it, they put it on a paper, so it does go on a paper.
But.
Yes, but. At ease, man. Bark.
That would be dumb. Let's see if we get a rollover out of Lee Merriweather.
I like to get a rollover.
The most you'll get from me is a sit-up.
Sit-up. Come to her, so come she tried
That's
to
a smart
teach
answer. That's
hot dog
good.
A rollover. Yeah. What do you say to that?
See, when you've done your car...
I'm sorry, I should be quiet, right?
You almost woke her up. It was time anyway, your nap's over.
Yeah.
I said bark.
Bark is good. Roll over, Betty.
I will, but first can we finish the game? Listen, I drew a picture of Jim.
Yeah?
That's a Boilermaker. That's
a Boilermaker, yeah. A beer and a shot is
but
a Boilermaker.
But I said bark, which is going up to him all.
Bark. We're trying to help you, Jim. But remember, it's a two-way street. You got to help us a little, too. Evelyn, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay, girl. See, listen, you know how some restaurants have signs that say, gentlemen must wear ties? Well, now, there's a new restaurant in Hollywood, and it's really weird. Their sign says, gentlemen must wear blanks. Weird new restaurant in Hollywood. Gentlemen must wear blanks. You got the idea?
Weird.
New restaurant, right.
Weird.
A weird new restaurant in Hollywood with a sign that says, gentlemen must wear blanks.
Come here, hon.
Hello, darling.
There's nothing wrong with that answer, is there?
Or
can't you read it?
Well, I can read it, yeah, but it's hard. It's hard for me to sit here and make editorial judgment because that's really not my function.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. What is that? Is that a weird? Yes, of course. Weird new restaurant. Gentlemen must wear blanks. Bill.
You notice that? He can talk down here,
yeah.
But he can't fill a card.
Really?
Oh, I just got it. She wins.
There's a good one, sure.
Do you know what time the 3 o'clock bus comes?
4:28. Yes. Now we're gonna have to start without you, Bill.
Okay.
Come on, Bill.
Come on, let's haul it.
Okay, Evelyn. You know signs, gentlemen must wear ties.
Yes.
Well, this new restaurant in Hollywood, really weird. Their sign says, gentlemen must wear blanks.
Shorts.
The applause is very lukewarm. Jim, I think you got a chance.
Right up there, we roll over
underwear.
Hello there. Now, what took you so long, Bill?
Oh, this is just so silly.
Just weird restaurant in Hollywood. Gentlemen must wear what?
I don't know. I have all the things I thought were naughty. So
what?
I could,
what?
I can't say them. If I could write them. No, I said an overcoat is so silly. I don't. Oh, somebody just gave me
dumb.
A new one. That,
all right, now the other five celebrities will give you an idea, a sampling of good answers,
yes,
beginning with Brett.
See, it took me
something
a little
classic.
Time.
To come up with something classic.
Certainly took me a little time to catch on. But then I realized what the question was all about. I said, pantyhose.
Well, now, there's one good possibility. Gentlemen must wear pantyhose. A weird restaurant, right?
I did throw away jockey shorts, though.
You threw away jockey shorts? What did you say?
I chose dresses over pantyhose with high heel pumps and feather boas. And may I just add, the food is marvelous.
Okay, Lee.
Therein lies the basic difference between Charles and myself. Style. I am basically simple. Skirts.
Gentlemen must wear skirts.
Richard? I have been to the restaurant.
Isn't it lovely?
Yes. And they insist you wear earrings.
Earrings. With
they
the feather
like
boas.
The long pin.
Must be coordinated. Totally coordinated, Betty.
Now watch how she gets an animal in on this.
No, I really didn't. But realizing her leaning in her answers, I said bras.
Bras is a very good one. So there we are. No score at the end of round one. Now we've got this for you. Hello. Goodbye. You gonna come back next time?
Definitely.
Okay.
Surely.
Pitcher's duel, zip to zip. Tight game. Two dingbats. Now, we hope you'll come back next time. What are you getting ready for, Charles?
No, I'm just showing you how versatile.
Say bye-bye,
Sheridan.
Join us next time for Match Game 76. Gene Rayburn here. Goodbye. Wow.